we are using. Because when you try to brew a coffee, you need to have the same temperature with the water and with the cup that you will be putting in so that it won't get cold too fast. Okay. Next is we will now discard the hot water. Ilapaabot ng coffee, thanks. Okay, now we can start brewing our coffee from India. So first and foremost, we have to pour enough water, around 50 ml, just enough for us to brew it, or to wet the coffee bed on top. So this process, known in the community, and this is known as dilution. So what does this do in our coffee cup? This allows our coffee to release its gas in the form of aroma. No, we have to allow the coffee to release its aroma for at least 30 seconds before we try to brew, or before we try to pour the rest of the water. We will be eating for our coffee. Okay. Then after 30 seconds, we can now continue to pour our water. Now, the good thing about the RDOB system is that when you try to pour, starting in the middle, in a slow circular motion outward, it helps the coffee to be extracted more compared to other designs. Why is that? Because if you can see, if you've seen before, the design of the V60 has this spiral ridges inside. And when you try to pour in a slow circular motion, it causes the coffee bed to spin around, which causes the agitation, or the agitating of the coffee. So what is the agitation of this process due to the coffee? It helps us, people who are brewing coffee at home, to release more of the coffee flavor from our Indian coffee. Now, technically, the idea behind the agitation is we're trying to steer the coffee bed to extract more. But instead of steering the coffee bed itself, we just have to pour it in a slow circular motion for us to have it moving around. And thus, we're going, it helps us to get more of the flavors that we want from the coffee.